back. This is Buy Now, Sell Now. It's a pretty jam-packed show. We've been talking to lots of corporates on their earnings as well as getting you top recommendations. In fact, let's move straight to Sanjeev Nautiyal. He's the Managing Director and CEO at SBI Life to talk about the strong growth that they witnessed as their new business premium margins as well improved in the quarter gone by. Welcome to the show. To begin with, sir, congratulations on a strong performance. The value of the new business premium is up almost 34% on year, and we're seeing an improvement in the value of the new business margins. What do you think led to all of this?
Actually, at SBI Life, we have focused more on the individual business, and because of which the individual rated premium business has gone up by 31%. And we have become the clear market leader in the individual rated business piece. And the renewals have also actually come in very steady, very strong. And we were able to achieve 106% of the target that we had set for ourselves at the beginning of the year.
All right. Mr. Nautiyal, how do you see the product mix on protection business? And also, what's the scope of improvement in margins going forward?
We would scale it up to around 8 to 10% this financial year, and we would be banking on credit life to give us the substantial upswing. You would be aware that State Bank of India has a lot of home loan business and other retail loans that it does. So we are going to ramp up our penetration from 52% currently to 60% plus. We are also tying up with many public sector and private banks and NBFCs to see that we are able to provide the full suite of insurance business to their customers and focusing more on the credit life. By credit life, we will get margins to the extent of 60-70%, and this should stand us in good stead as far as the margin on VNB is concerned.
So what has led to the high embedded value growth of 15% and an ROE of 18%? Do you think that the outlook ahead on EV looks encouraging?
So we are looking at 18 to 20% return on embedded value, and I think persistency has been very good. 83% is the 13th month persistency that we achieved, and as you go along up to the 61st month, I think we start doing better than the peers as the duration goes ahead. So persistency is absolutely very crucial for sustaining the embedded value. We are also looking at avoiding surrenders. We are also looking at operationally generating a lot of efficiency in our operations. I think so all said and done, the business that we've done in the last years, the kind of renewals that we are getting, the kind of persistency we are doing, and the kind of assumptions that we take on the mortality charges and the other assumptions that we take into the scheme of things, they are all holding us well to give us the growth in the embedded value.
Okay, cost ratios have fallen 11.2% and persistency has improved. What is the scope of further improvement in both of these factors?
Persistency, we are aiming to reach 85% by the end of this year. We are already at 83% as far as the 13th month persistency goes, and we'll improve the numbers in the other categories up to 61st month. So operationally, we are very, very gung-ho because we are also launching a lot of digital initiatives which are already there and strengthening them to see that end-to-end, the sourcing and the servicing part is taken over by the digital platform. So persistency will be doing very well.
And your private market share has increased to about 22%. What is your strategy in place in order to grow the private market share? Do you have any inorganic growth plans as well lined up?
I think we've improved our market share in individual rated premium by 1.1%, and that is for the industry as well as on the private players comparison. We will continue to do well in individual rated premium, and on the group side we will look at group term insurance selectively because we would like to see that the mortality part is well buffered. And we will also push for the credit life business. So we are looking at improving the the market share in the individual rated side, and we will, on the group side, we will push with the group term insurance and the credit life part.
Okay, Mr. Nautiyal, we leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining us, Suniti. Now, wish you all the very best for the forthcoming quarters as well. That's SBI Life for you. The numbers, of course, were good, but the stock is just a bit about lackluster today in trade. Quick break right here on the show. When we come back, we're going to be talking about commodities.